Welcome back, everybody. My name is Sync930, and this is a review for the latest Far Cry 5 expansion, Lost on Mars. Lost on Mars is a lighthearted and goofy single-player adventure starring Nick Reyes and Far Cry comic relief Herc as they attempt to stop an alien invasion originating from the Red Planet. The expansion features a brand new open-world location to explore, filled with new enemy types, new weapons, new gadgets, and new open-world quests to complete. To start this off, let's discuss this expansion's story. Lost on Mars kicks off with Herc forcibly dragging Nick Reyes into a space adventure with him. After being abducted onto the surface of Mars, you're given control and will eventually run into part of Herc. Herc explains that he needs help reactivating the AI on the planet to help prevent a space crab horde from invading Earth, and after a few tutorial missions explaining the new mechanics, you're let loose to clean up objective markers on the map, typical Ubisoft style. The story is pretty predictable, and it makes fun of itself for being so, with Nick constantly commenting on how what they're doing seems suspicious. And Herc is painfully ignorant as you'd expect. Herc's dialogue overall really isn't that bad though, despite being very immature at times. There's some fun societal references, including a nod to Stranger Things, Tremors, and a lot of other pop culture. It does get a bit exhausting though, as Herc literally doesn't go a single minute without shutting up. Every single objective, every enemy encounter, and discovery warrants a comment from Herc. But honestly, that's really the only interesting thing about this expansion. The actual gameplay and environment is incredibly dull and repetitive. Mars is about as empty and boring as you'd expect. There's some great terrain design and a few unique twists to certain areas of the map, like an area with more fog cover, or an area that disables your jetpack, but it's still a big empty red planet with nothing to see outside of the designated research buildings. The space crab enemies are pretty cool looking, but unfortunately, there's not really much variety to them. You have the standard tremor type enemy that will spawn and jump out of the ground if you touch the surface, forcing you to consistently play the floor as lava as you explore. Then there's the ranged enemies that fire projectiles from long distance but are easier to kill. There's a stronger brute enemy type that takes a lot more damage to kill. There's smaller crabs that are very easy to kill but are fast and will explode on impact. Aerial aliens that look like pterodactyls and will shoot projectiles at you. And finally, the queens, which are more rare but sport a lot of health and shoot projectiles at you. These enemy types also have enhanced variants that are slightly stronger and feature a different coloration, but outside of that, they look practically identical. There's a few other rare enemy types, but I don't want to spoil anything more. Weapons are probably one of the weakest component of this expansion. There's only really two weapon models designed here, but with different colors and ammunition types. The rifles and shotguns look practically identical, save for some very small differences in detail. They're so similar to each other, I often mixed up which weapon was in my inventory. The saving grace here is that the further you progress, the more interesting the weapons become. The weapon models still look mostly the same, but some have heat-seeking plasma, one's a beam rifle that can be used to snipe enemies, and there's even a laser beam pistol that turns enemies into cows and chickens. In addition to these weapons, there's also some new grenades and items. There's a standard explosive grenade, a shock grenade that seems to stun enemies, and a chicken grenade that spawns an explosive chicken that draws enemies together and blows them apart. You can also use an invincibility item called the cock blocker and an invisibility item, but I didn't really get much use out of this. There's also a variation of Far Cry's bait system with the queen hearts. Throwing these will cause enemies to attack each other, which was effective when being swarmed by a ton of different enemy types. The missions are another weak aspect of this expansion. After the initial tutorial mission, it's soon apparent that the rest of the expansion will just have you flying from point to point on the map and repeating the same boring activate and defend events. In addition to these, you'll also be climbing towers. It's really surprising that they thought this was a good idea. In fact, they even joke about how unoriginal it is, yet they put it in anyway. To be fair, the jetpack device makes these tower climbing bits a bit more interesting, and the towers are significantly taller than anything we've seen in a Far Cry game prior, which makes them fun to climb, but it's still repetitive nonetheless. And finally, there's a collectathon mission, where you're forced to run around and pick up Herc's scattered body parts to help rebuild his body. This quest was fun to complete, as each item had a funny name and gave Herc an excuse to say something goofy, but the payoff was incredibly disappointing, making me wonder why I even wasted my time completing the objective. Overall, this Lost on Mars expansion was not really that great. It has some decent humor, some nice visuals, and is a nice distraction for about 2.5 hours. But most of that playtime was repetitive objective grinding just to get to a predictable ending. Unlike the previous expansion, which I actually enjoyed for its emphasis on stealth mechanics and interesting structure, this Mars expansion takes the worst from the Far Cry series as of late and puts it on full display. Now, if you already have the season pass, it's still worth checking out. But if you're picking these up separately, this one might be worth skipping. I hope you guys enjoyed this review, and if you want to see more videos like this, don't forget to like and subscribe for videos posted every week.